channel. This is Matt from Surprise Comics. I have a new haul for you guys. So this is books primarily I've picked up at the amazing Las Vegas Comic Con. I went ahead and made a day trip up there to check the con out, see what was going on. And I found some pretty good deals. So these right here are exclusive to the con. This is Batman number one. This is, I think it's a Philip Tan cover. It's a pretty cool cover. You have all the different iterations of Harley through the years behind Batman. So I went ahead and picked that up. This is another exclusive they had from previous conventions. This is the Harley Quinn number 19. This was an exclusive from a Image Expo that they were carrying. This is The Walking Dead number 94, a very stunning cover. They recreated this in a scene, I don't think it was last season, but the season before, where they had the, wasn't Michonne, it was, I forget her name, but she laid down on the pile of dead walkers. It was kind of creepy and weird and didn't make any sense. I remember watching, people were trying to make sense of it. It was just basically to recreate this cover image. It really didn't have any real purpose. Then also at the opening place where they had all the exclusives, for some reason they had this out there too. I guess it's because Kevin Eastman was signing at the con. And so I went ahead and picked up another copy of the Kevin Eastman variant for Batman Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles number one. A pretty high priced book, got it at a really good deal. I think it was $25 I paid for it. Typically goes between $40 and $50 on eBay, so could have passed that up. Now, those of you who've been following my videos for a while, you know when I go to cons, there's one booth particularly I always look for. And I was disappointed at the last con I went to because this booth wasn't there. There's so many cons going on, but the guy who runs this con, this is actually his booth. He sells lots of variants at super cheap prices. I was finally able to get a copy of this. Is Batman and Robin 23. This is a Jason Todd criminal cover. I've been kind of on the hunt for that for a year or so and finally found it cheap. I got paid 10 bucks for it. Got a copy of Grayson number one. This is a 1-in-100 Michael Janin cover. This one can go for quite a bit online, so I was super excited to get it for just $20. I did get two copies of this at a previous show for $5 a piece. So, you know, I'm still not going to complain getting it for $20 because that's well under what it's worth. Got another copy. This is a much higher grade copy than the previous copy I got of Superman American Alien number one. Excited to get that. I picked up a couple copies previously. I've had number three before, but at the price he was selling them at, I was definitely going to pick up another. I got number four as well. Picked up a copy of the 120. These are all 125 variants. Different artists did each issue. This is number five. I previously picked up Superman American Alien number six, so I didn't need to get it from him. And I got number seven. This one is really hot cover. You know, I basically, Jock is one of my favorite cover artists, or artists in general. And, you know, I've noticed that lately he's really picked up a lot of popularity. It seems like his covers are always going fast and going up in price real quick. So, you know, you got your usual suspects. You know, whenever you see a J. Scott Campbell or Adam Hughes variant, you know those are going to be valuable right away. You could probably add Jock to that list now because it seems like the last few that he's done. He did the Batman Europa one. That one didn't take off quite as high, but it was really hot when it first came out. And then this one too really, really took off price-wise. Let's get these out of the way. Super excited. I got the entire set now of variants for that series. New Suicide Squad number two, 125 variant. Love this cover. Not a huge Joker's Daughter fan, but definitely pick that up. Superman Unchained number nine. It's a wraparound cover, Jim Lee sketch. And speaking of Jim Lee sketch, I also picked up Harley Quinn and the Suicide Squad April Fool's special. One shot. This is a sketch variant of it. This one is another one that was really popular when it came out. It still fetches 40 to 50 bucks. I think I paid 20 for it. I love these Batman 66 covers. And I've been picking them up as I see them. I'm super high, excited to get the Harley Quinn one. I picked up this cover because it's I just love that cover with the hyenas. I got another copy of Harley Quinn number 26. This is the 125 variant. This is the first appearance of Red Tool. It's a cameo on the last page. For Red Tool, you know, if he's going to be a thing, this is the book to get. His full appearance is in number 27, but that one doesn't seem to be grabbing the attention. If you get these good books graded, it does note that this is the first appearance of Red Tool on the number 26s. I did go ahead and grab a number 27 variant as well. His first full appearance. And I got number 28 also. So I don't have that one previously, so I figured why not get one. Last book I picked up from this booth was Harley Quinn and Her Little Black Book number 3, the 125 variant. This book was super valuable when it first came out. It's kind of died down a bit, but it still goes for $30 to $40 range. It was going at $80 at one point. This goes to show if you're flipping books, you know, the faster you can flip them, usually pays off, but you know, other times it doesn't. It's kind of it's a game. You got to kind of have a feel for it. But I'm feeling this comic will be probably pretty valuable just by the popularity of the artist and the characters on it. Did some digging around while I was there. A lot of different dealers had dollar bins, so this is kind of just a collection of all the dollar or the best dollar books I got while I was there. I got a few more than what I'm showing you, but just to keep the video reasonable. I got this Wonder Woman number 63. This is a Brian Bolan cover. Not a lot of value to it. I think it's like a $10 to $15 book depending on grade, but you know, for a buck, definitely gonna pass it up. I got this Nightwing number 4. When I first got into collecting about 3 years ago, I think it was, maybe it's four, time flies. It's 3 years ago, three and a half. This book was like a $40 book. It was the most valuable book in the run. Nightwing was real popular. It is the first appearance of a character that is like some shapeshifter. Looks like Nightwing here. Low print run, hard to find high grade. Still goes for like 10 to 15, but nowhere near where it was going for. But for a buck, you know, I was definitely not going to pass it up. I picked up a couple copies of this. I'll show you the one, Green Lantern Zero. Still find this in dollar bins all the time. This is the first full appearance of Simon Baz. There is another first appearance of Simon Baz that was a Free Comic Book Day comic. That one isn't really as recognized, doesn't have as much value. So this is the one you want to get. Speaking of first appearances, X-Factor number 23. This is the first cameo of Archangel. He's in like three or four panels. This book obviously has a little bit of value, but you know, if you want to get Archangel's first appearance, 24. And when he's on the cover is actually the one to get. And I think that has a lot to do with the first appearance cameo debate. It's like who's on the cover. I picked up this J. Scott Campbell cover, Batman 563 for a buck. And the final dollar book I'll show you is Batman Annual number 25, second print. I was super shocked to find this in the dollar bin. It does have a little bit of like dirt and grime on it, just with this white cover, but it might be able to clean up, and other than that, it's in really good shape. So another big purchase I made was I bought the entire run, but I'll show you these Secret Wars. There's number 1 and number 8. Number 8's famous for the cover, the introduction of the origin of the black costume. Paid a decent price for it. Probably didn't get as cheap as I wanted to, but really as cheap as I wanted to get it wasn't going to happen anyways. When I did get it home, I opened this up and I noticed I did get the misprint copy. which kind of helped a little bit with the sting of not getting it for as good of a deal. So let me see. If you have a copy of this, you should open it up. You go straight to the middle of the book. You'll see there's a picture of Galactus where he's miscolored. This is a misprint. I'm not sure how rare it is, but supposedly it is more rare. When you get it graded, they'll note it in the grade or in the description of the book. And it does, you know, it will go for a little bit more than the regular copy will. So if you have this, pick it up, take a look at, see if you got the misprint. You might have a little bit more value. Or you might have to find out, now you have to look for another copy because you want to own the whole set, including the misprint. So, yeah, it's one of the story arcs that every collection should have, and mine does now. This book I've been on the hunt for, and you see just such ridiculous price ranges for these books. This is Batman 428. This is The Death of Jason Todd, if the cover didn't give it away. And I've been kind of trying to hunt down the set. And to me, there's a certain value for the set and how much you can get them individually and stuff. But then when people buy them, whenever I look for them in auctions and stuff, they just go for so much more than you'd expect. So I picked this one up for 10. I've already have one of the other ones, so I still need two more to complete this. I've read the graphic novel, so I'm not terribly pressed. This was a lit book on my list for the top 10 books I was looking for this year. But when I put it on my list, I wasn't necessarily just looking for this one book. I was looking for the entire story arc. So I don't know if I kind of crossed it off, but not really. I got a copy of New Avengers number 4. This is the first appearance of Maria Hill. There's a variant for this one I've been on the hunt for. I haven't found it yet. That has Jessica Jones on the cover. This is a book I've actually accidentally bought two other New Avengers books with Spider-Woman on the cover, thinking they were the one because I was going off the cover and I knew it was a Spider-Woman cover, and this time I finally got it right. I think I paid $2 for that one. Wolverine Origins number 10. This is the variant. This is the first appearance of Dokken. It's not the variant that you want. I don't know if this is even as valuable as a regular cover, because the regular cover is actually a little bit cooler than this one. But with all the talk about Dokken showing up in the next Wolverine movie, along with X-23, I figured this would be the one. This would be a good chance to pick it up cheap. I think I had this in my last haul, but I found it again for just $5. That's Amazing Spider-Man 410. Just a popular Carnage story. I don't think it's a key in any way. Or maybe it's like the first, I don't know. I won't say anything else because I don't know. Next section, these are a copy of the Batman number 4, is the first appearance of the Court of Owls, and this is the third print. All these Batman, early Batman books all had multiple printings, and there's definitely collectors out there who like to be the completionists and pick up these multiple printings, and I saw them for a good price, so I didn't want to pass it up, and so I picked that one up. I think all these were like $4 or $5. Here's the third printing of number 5. And it's just the regular covers with just a slight paint change. And then this one I was super excited to get. It's one of my favorite covers. It's Batman number 6, second print with the red background. I think I like the original background a little bit better, but you know, definitely not hating on this one. So, and then my big pickup for the con, this is a book I've had on my to get list for years, and the price is always more than I wanted to spend, but definitely what it was worth. And so, you know, I went with big hopes to find some Bronze Age Batman books that I wanted to get. I wanted to get a Batman 251, you know, hopefully 232, 222. There's these bigger books that are going to cost me a little bit more money, but when I got to the con, you know, I see one that, you know, I saw 251 that I would be willing to pay 154. Say, how much do you want for that? The guy's, you know, 300 for this, and I'm like, it's just not worth that much. So, you know, I had to pass up on it. But, you know, after looking around, I did find this one. You know, it wasn't on my top 10 list, but if I had done the top 11 list, this is probably the next book I would put on there. And speaking of Jock, it's Batman number 880. Awesome, awesome cover. I got this for a good deal, $30 or $40 less than what it's going for online in this grade. This is a super high grade copy. You know, with the press, because there's a couple tiny little things that might be able to get up to a 9.8, but I feel pretty confident saying it's a 9.4, 9.6 in the shape it is in right now. So this is one I definitely will be getting graded eventually. It's one that's going to go in my personal collection. It's not for flipping or reselling. A lot of these books I'm showing you, I bought with the expectation of flipping them short term. But this one's definitely one that's going into the vault. I probably will wait to see if I can't get Jock and Snyder to sign this book before I get it graded. Maybe at San Diego this year if I can swing it. So that's it for my convention haul. So it was a pretty good haul, pretty nice show. There's a lot of people there, but the convention wasn't really that big of a convention. At least not compared to some of the other ones I've been to. But, you know, if you're in the Vegas area, definitely not a bad show to go to. This next little lot I'll show just to get them out of the way. This is a haul I picked up on Atomic Comics. And, you know, this guy had these books for sale, and he was in Canada. And if you ordered $50 worth of books, he would ship them for free. So I found, you know, a $5 book I really wanted. And I looked through the store and found a couple other ones I liked. And then I, you know, really started digging deep into the store because I had to get that $50 mark. Because, you know, at some point, the free shipping pays for, you know, it's like I can pay shipping and spend around $50 and get, you know, four less comics than if I spent $50 and got free shipping. So pick up that one, Amazing Man 700. I think it's the second print variant. I thought, why not? I love these 300 cover swipes. So I went ahead and picked that up. This one, a few months ago, they had the Neil Adams variant month. This is the Harley Quinn did the variant of this one. And I kind of like, you know, ever since that, I've been kind of looking for the Neil Adams covers. Like, get them cheap enough, especially on the ones that aren't like key books. I'll pick it up. I think I got this for $10. It's a pretty nice grade too. It's probably fine plus condition. You know, it's a little bit of, you know, the cover's not as white as you'd like, but not bad. Wonder Woman number one, or Blackest Night Wonder Woman number one. This is a 1/25 variant. This one I already showed, so I won't go into it too much. It's funny, I paid that. I think I put this in my cart for like $10, which was a fair deal then, and then I found it at the show a week later for $5, so I decided I'd better have two. This book I picked up, not even really realizing what it was when I put it in my cart. This is X-23, the Marvel Next. This is the second print. And this book has kind of blown up as far as, you know, X-23 books have all kind of had this huge jump. Like, it had a mini, but it had a good jump like a month and a half ago. And then it cooled off for a little bit. And then it had this other just gigantic jump probably 2-3 weeks ago. And this one got up in the $40, $50 range for this book. I couldn't believe what NYX or NYX or whatever they call it, number four, the second appearance. You know, that's like, people were charging $200-$300 for that book now. And it was like a $5 book, you know, 3 months ago. So it's kind of surprising the popularity of this character. So I picked this up. This one's going to be a nice little book here. So super excited to get that. But the whole reason I went to Atomic Avenue was to look for this book. And the reason I bought all these other books was to get this one. It's Flashpoint number two. the 1 in 25 variant. This is a George Perez, I think Ivan Rice cover. You can see that it's the thing that kind of is the cause of the apocalyptic world that is in Flashpoint, where Wonder Woman and Aquaman got together and Mera got upset. And rather than Wonder Woman just like, you know, making her stop, and you know, because what can Mera really do to Wonder Woman? Not a whole lot. Not that Mera is a pushover, but she's not Wonder Woman. Wonder Woman, you know, said, "Oh, she attacked me, so I cut her head off," was her explanation to Aquaman. Not that. And so that's really what caused the end of the world. But I have the Flashpoint graphic novel. I read that a couple weeks ago, and I was flipping through the back covers, and I saw the back, and they have all the different covers on there. I saw that one, and I knew I had to go get it. So that's my haul. Thanks for watching. Like, comment, subscribe. And if you're in the Phoenix area, come to the Glendale Toy Show next week. Have a booth there. If not, happy hunting. Good luck finding comics. And I hope you had a good time.